greed, I'm talking of in the corporate context, and we'll explore many hues as we go along of greed, but I'm sure you know, we would all very curious to hear your views.
See, once we have chosen, there was a time about 20 years ago, 25 years ago, when India was vouching that we are a socialist country. Socialism is a watered-down version of communism. When you don't have the courage to be a communist, you become a socialist. Which has always been one of the serious problems with our nation, that we don't have the courage to say who we are, what do we intend. We'll always beat about the bush, we'll always beat about the bush, which leaves everybody in confusion, you know, because nobody knows where we want to go. So, communism as an idea is a fantastic idea. Karl Marx might have known a lot about economics, but he knows very little about human beings. He predicted that the richest nations in the world will become communist. People will share their wealth with each other, and how wonderful it's going to be the world. It's a fantastic dream. It's a beautiful dream. It's one of the best dreams the world has dreamed, that everybody will be equal, everybody will have everything, nobody has to… You know, it's by our need, not by our greed. You may produce $1 billion, I may produce nothing, but you are willing to share with me. There's a very beautiful story, incident which happened when Mark Twain visited. He was so excited. Wow, rich are going to share their wealth with the poor and everybody's going to be equal, equal opportunity for everyone. This is fantastic. Everybody wanted to go. Lots of thinkers and authors from America traveled to Russia because they were so excited. This is it, the world is going to change. So Mark Twain was walking in a country road. A country Russian gentleman was walking in front of him with two hens under his arms. He ran up to him, caught up, and he said, "Comrade, are you really a communist?" He said, "Yes, I am. I'm a party member." He said, "Is it true that if you have two bungalows, you will give away one to your comrade?" "Of course. If I have two bungalows, I will give away one to my comrade. I'm a party member. I'm an office bearer." "If you have two carriages, will you give away one to somebody who needs it?" "Of course, I'm a party member, I'm the president in my village, I have to and I will." "You have two hens, will you give away one of them?" "What the hell, that's all I have." So people wanted to give away what they don't have. So, when the poorest of the poor on the planet started talking about communism, communism became ugly. It's such a great idea. If the rich and the wealthy and the capable had taken it, world would have become an ashram. Yes, it would have been a perfect spiritual setting, really, if the rich had taken it. Now the poor took up the idea. What they could not earn, they want to take it by beating. Banditry became a philosophy. What should have been a fantastic process of sharing and giving and an embrace of humanity turned into an ugly idea. Most horrific things were done. During Joseph Stalin's time, they say over 27 million Russians died. This is three times the number that died in World War II. That many people, Russian people, died because the poor are trying to share something that they don't have. If the rich had shared, what a wonderful world it would have been. And the poorest of the poor talking about communism made it ugly. If the richest and the most capable on the planet had spoken about communism, it would have been the greatest idea. So we gave up that idea and now we chose capitalism. Somebody very prominent in the world declared, "Capitalism is dead," you know. So, I was with him recently and he was talking, see, they printed like these headlines that I said capitalism is dead. Why it was called capitalism is because capital was only with certain people at that time. Now you have come ICICI Bank, I can also have capital.
Indeed.
Somebody else can also have capital. This was not the reality of the world 100 years ago. Only a few people on the planet were capable of capital. Nobody else had capital. So it became titled as capitalism. Now we are calling it market economy, driven by the market. Market means profit. No profit, you shouldn't talk about a marketplace. And when you have set up such a system, there is no room. In your vocabulary, there's no room for the word greed. If you use the word greed, what it means is you're operating market economy with communism going around in your head. Only if you're a communist, you can talk about greed. If you're market economy, don't talk about greed, talk about better laws. If somebody is making $1 billion per day, let's tax him. 900 million, you can tax him and that will be distributed anyway. But enough to give him incentive to go on, not to take away his spirit. So this is how capitalism is managed. Here you don't talk about this whole corporate social responsibility, I think it's funny. It is just an eyewash. Instead of that, the government, if the administration, if it has the necessary sense, you can bring the right kind of policies where businesses can grow unbridled, but it will naturally benefit the rest of the society. This can be done with simple laws, taxation and other kinds of laws. Business laws can do this. There's no need to talk about service, there's no need to talk about greed. Everybody can live with dignity, because if you are the receiving end of the service, you lose your dignity. If you are at the giving end of the service, you go to heaven, both are wrong.
What I hear Sadhguru saying is profit is a good motive. And if you call it greed, that greed is good. And
greed is
I
good.
I think that is something that, you know, profit is something that
companies recognize. If you look at the definition of greed, what is greed? See, for somebody who is walking to his workplace or his home, somebody who rides a bicycle and refuses to take him on the bicycle is greedy man. Somebody who is riding a bicycle sees a man driving a Maruti car and he thinks he's greedy. Just single man driving a Maruti car, he could take me, his family and my family in the Maruti car, because Indians are able to squeeze, you know. A man who is driving a Maruti car, when a Mercedes or a BMW whizzes past him, he says vulgarity of greed. A man who is driving BMW looks at a man who is driving a Bugatti and he thinks that is greed. So who is to set this definition for what is greed? I'm saying once you have chosen market economy, there is no room for that vocabulary in your life. You understand greed is the driving force. Now, it is for the laws to manage the greed so that your greed benefits everybody else. In African lore, there is a saying, when the lion feeds, everybody else gets fed. So if you're a lion, you have a big capability. When you feed, it is the laws which should make it in such a way, if you make profit, everybody should live well. Instead of talking about greed and service and corporate social responsibility, I don't know why they're deviating themselves into all this.
So stay focused on maximizing profitability.
Yes.
Tax appropriately and